Actually, media query is a CSS 3 module. What it does is it helps us to query our devices. For example, with the help of media query, we can detect whether the screen resolution is this much, if the screen width is this much, or if we have a, if the screen's orientation is landscape or portrait, so that we can write necessary codes which will help to make our layout see better layouts in different screens, different resolutions, different orientations, etc., etc. Yeah. No, that's something which is called hacking. That's a hack, CSS hacks. This is not something related to that. These are something which we can detect device. For example, we can detect what actually a device width is, what actually the device screen size is, what actually a device's orientation is. And we can change if I have a device width of 1500 pixel, then I want, maybe I want a bigger image. The same, with that same code, I can switch and just write if max width 1500, I need to use a specific image. If max width 300 pixel, then I need to switch to another image. Yeah. Okay. And these are some of the logics that we can use in media queries. And the comma is something or. Yeah.
Would you please explain that? So, we start with at media.
At media.
Simply writing.
Querying a media. And yeah. At media, then all. We have a lot of media types. For example, screen. Screen is a media type. Print. Etc. etc. All means everything. In screen, print, everything. And max width. If the screen's maximum width is this much and minimum width is this much, then this tile will be rendered. Yeah, with the help of this, we can easily detect if this is a mobile. And here, if max width 600 or min width 800, this is a and media not all. This is not. This is the simple logic in media queries. And yeah. It's simple. Media queries, it's nothing much complex to use media queries in your CSS sheets. This much code will be enough. Sorry? No. No. Either now don't try to identify your browser, identify your. Yeah, browser identification is not encouraged. You just try something called a feature detection. We have JavaScript libraries like Modernizer to detect a feature. If a browser support touch or something like that, and with the help of that, we can up to an extent we can target browsers. And Sumil will explain, or Sumil will give you a quick introduction on media queries.
Thank you, Sharaz. Hi, in this section, we will be discussing about some useful media queries. I am Sumil, UI Development DBG. Let us see some of the media queries aspect ratio, orientation, color, and monochrome. First, aspect ratio. With this media query, we will be able to query the device aspect ratio. Aspect ratio have a lots since the birth of smartphone and tablets. Older display commonly have aspect ratio of 4:3 and 5:3. But now with the new HD video standards, we see the displays at 16:9 and 16:10.
So do you know there is aspect ratio? I hope that everyone know what an aspect ratio is, right? That is whenever there is an image we want to resize it. We will always make sure that it keeps that aspect ratio. And normally the screens that is monitor has the same aspect ratio. Whenever it is a bigger screen, it is just diagonally increasing so that width and height increase or keeping the aspect ratio. But right now in the mobiles, we have different aspect ratios. Some will be that is almost square type, or some will be. So it is hard for us to write a code to keep in all aspect ratio, work properly in all aspect ratio. So this media query will help us to understand or identify the aspect ratio of that device and show the layout or create the layout based on that. So at the rate media, so the screen and then device aspect ratio. So if the device aspect ratio is 16:10, just do this CSS. That is what the query is.
The orientation of the device can be used to create a custom layout. This may be useful for positioning menus and button in place where they are easily accessible for users' thumbs.
So this will help us to query the orientation. That is whether it is they're mostly used for mobiles, right? Only for mobiles, right? Orientation for that is if it is for handheld devices. So this media query returns whether it is in portrait mode or landscape mode the person is viewing that website. Okay. So that based on that we can know that is how the person will be using the thumbs on this side or this side, and then we can determine how to do the layout of menu and structure like that.
Another one, color. The color media features is used to check if the device is color compatibility by using device. If you want to target only a non-color device, we can use like this.
What is non-color
device? Means if a device is not having any color information. If it does not have any color information screen in its screen,
okay.
Black and white. That's it.
If the device is a black and white or a color device.
The last one, monochrome. This which is applies to a grayscale device. Next one.
We can query monochrome devices using the media query monochrome, and most of the monochrome devices.
To apply the specifics.
What happens is that our images will be in color, and we'll be always switching off our images.
it's not so appealing while seeing our images in monochrome devices. So we usually switch off images in monochrome devices. So this is a simple technique to do that. Media and query whether it's a monochrome device, and if it's a monochrome device, then the image will not be shown there.
To apply the specific style to all the monochrome device, we can use the monochrome value. We can also use this value to give the style to device with a certain number of bits per pixels. With this concluding my section.
Sumin, my question is, can we identify a device using media queries? Like, my question is like this. I want to prepare for the iOS device. Like, I hope you heard about the Retina designs.
Yeah.
I want to identify the Retina display. For that, how do you identify?
If it's a Retina display or not, with the help of pixel density.
How do we do that?
Here, the WebKit main device pixel ratio 2.
It's always WebKit, right?
Yeah. Because we are targeting iOS devices. Yeah. If you want this link, then surely I can. Here we have. I can share it in a Coffee DBG Facebook page. Okay.